The limit comparison test is very nice, of course, but requires you to find another series. A test where you only use the series itself would be nicer. Fortunately, such a test exists, the ratio tests. Let us see how this test works in this video. So, what are you going to do? You are going to look at the terms of the series, their respective sizes in the tail. So what you are going to compare an plus 1 divided by an. You're going to look how fast your tail is going to decreasing to zero. So you take an plus 1 divided by an. You take the absolute value. I want to look into tail, so you take the limit n to infinity and you compute this limit. Suppose it's called L. And now you can have three cases. Either your L is smaller than 1, in that case, so the series converges, or your L is bigger than 1. In that case, your an plus 1 will be bigger than your an all the time, so you already guess it's going to diverge, or your L equals 1. Well, then your an is, plus 1 is approximately as big as your an. So let's see exactly what happens. Well, if your L will be smaller than 1, that means if we look at your quotient an plus 1 over an, your L will be somewhere over here. Well, you take absolute value, so it will be bigger than 0 and it's smaller than 1, so 1 is over here. If your L is smaller than 1, there is some room in between for some r, so we also have some value r in between your L and your 1, so we have some small r here. What does it mean, the limit equals L? Limit equals L, that means that eventually, if you are far enough with your small n, that all your an plus 1s over an gets very close to your L. So they get in this region over here, provided you are small enough. In particular, if you are far enough in your series, they will all be below also this value r over here, close to L and below your r. So you know if you are far enough, that an plus 1 is smaller than r times an. Well, you can do this then repeatedly, and then you know an plus 2 is smaller than r times an plus 1 is smaller than r times an, smaller than r squared times an, or an plus k is smaller than r to the power k times an. And now we can use this to show that our series absolutely convergent. So how do we do this? Well, we take the sum absolute values of an. First we take the first part. This is a finite number of terms which is always convergent. You just add capital N terms, so that's always fine. And you take the other terms. That could be the problem. Well, we know that the other terms are smaller than r to the power k times an absolute value. That's this inequality over here. And now the nice part is this a capital N is just a constant number can be taken in front of the series. And then we see that we just have a geometric series with a small r smaller than 1. So we can compute the sum that equals first term divided by 1 minus r. So that's just a number. And this is also a number, which means that our original series is smaller than one number plus another number. So it is convergent. So that's why series converges absolutely if this L is smaller than 1. Well, if your L is bigger than 1, you can do a similar argument. If your then here we have R1, of course bigger than 0 still, and your L is bigger than 1. And then you can find, of course, again an R in between. And then you know that if you're far enough in your series, all your quotient an plus 1 over an will be close to L, so in particular over here somewhere. They will be bigger than r. So that's what it says over here. An plus 1 is bigger than r times an. And then do the same argument. An plus k is bigger than r to the power k times an, where this r is now bigger than 1. So try to compute the sum exactly in the same way. Sum n equals 1 to infinity an, sum of the first terms. And it's bigger than now with the r to the power k times an. But the second series is a geometric series which with r bigger than 1, so it is divergent. So that's why this series here diverges if L is bigger than 1. It's even bigger than the divergent series. Well, what about the case in between L equals exactly 1? Well, then you don't know what's going on. Try, for example, the 1 over n and the 1 over n squared. They both have as their L 1, but this one is divergent, this one is convergent. So if L equals 1, you do not know what's going to happen. Your series can be either convergent or divergent. And that's also the weakness of this test. It tells in a lot of cases whether your series is convergent or divergent, but sometimes it doesn't tell you either of them.